Hey, you're there? You?
Yes, you
and everyone who want to speed up their website. I'm your man Nar, and I'm here with some time-saving tips and harsh truths about removing unused CSS and JavaScript. So I get it, you get it, and Google gets it that you want to speed up your website. So Google PageSpeed Insight told you to remove unused JavaScript and CSS and that it will make your website at least a couple of seconds faster. But what exactly is unused CSS and JavaScript? How to remove them or can you remove them? And finally, how to actually speed up your website instead. So stay tuned, because I'm going to be speaking about all of these in exactly 30 seconds. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah. If you create or run a website and want to improve it, then my channel and website is for you. Head over to my website, yourmannar.com, and you will find tons of informative content, tips and tricks, ready-made websites with complex functionalities for sale, and most importantly, discounts for the best tools to improve your website's performance. Enjoy this video. I hope it will be valuable for you. As always, I'm your man Nar.
All right, I hope I wasn't too late from my promised 30 seconds. As always, this is the written article of the same tutorial. I will add it in the description of this video. It will be the first link, so you can go there and read it in case you don't like watching videos. I know a lot of people who actually don't like watching videos, so that's why I do this. So let's start. So what is actually unused CSS and JavaScript? It is actually the piece of code that your page loads, okay, but it doesn't use on that particular page. So whenever you go to a website, so let's say I go to tiktok.com, okay? This website loads tons of JavaScript and CSS, but it doesn't use all of them at once for just loading this page, okay? So if I go to PageSpeed, Google, I'm trying to explain this step by step so you guys can grasp the idea behind the entire process. I don't wanna just be the guy who just says, do this or do that. I want you to understand this, because I remember when I first tried to remove unused CSS and JavaScript, how confused I was and how confusing it was to actually understand what's going on. And trying to do it proved to be a waste of time for me, and I think for a lot of people. So when I go to tiktok.com, tested in the PageSpeed Insights, so it says reduced unused JavaScript. So what this is saying is that this page is loading more JavaScript than it needs, okay? So it loads, let's say, for another page, or sometimes it loads for some functionalities that it might not be used on this particular page or that time, but it loads. So this makes the website almost a second slower, okay? So what Google is saying is that go and identify unused CSS and JavaScript on every page and remove it, and that will speed up all your pages and ultimately your website. And what does actually this mean is that you have to go to right click inspect, go to sources, find coverage. If you don't find coverage in here, press Control Shift P, okay, and type in show coverage. Right, reload this. I already have the coverage in here, but in case you didn't, so we went to sources and coverage. All right, so this is where it says, okay, this page, let's pause this because we have nothing to do with this actually. So this says that such a weird position to stop, but yeah, so this says that the page loaded this all of this, and let's say this particular JavaScript had 60,000 bytes not used, okay? So it loaded around this much. So it has 660,000 bytes and almost half of it is unused. I'm sorry, I misread it. That's my bad, but you get the point. So it's loading this much, but only using this much. And the same thing goes for this CSS and JavaScript and this JavaScript. So you can see that it's loading more than it actually using, and you can say that this works on almost every website. If you go to facebook.com and you just right click, okay, so you can see that it's loading a lot of it. Even if you go to to the great human nar, you will find the same thing as well. So this is actually pretty normal, and almost every website I am yet to find a website who's not okay. So this is actually worse, but again, it's still fast. So this is the coverage insights. Okay, so what basically Google's saying is, go and identify each piece of code in here that is being called and not being used, or let's say it's being used halfway through, and only call the part that you need, on only call the CSS and JavaScript that you need on that particular page. So it is not only a headache. Okay, let's say you identify the codes, it's twice, and I cannot even imagine how hard it is to actually start removing it. And I even tried doing it once, and trust me, it was so bad. I have to remove this. I was watching some Dora before starting the tutorial. It was really, really hard, and it was really, really bad, and it's a waste of time, I promise you, and trust me. So you don't want to go there. So instead, if you want to speed up your website, there are actually multiple things that you can do. In fact, there's gtmetrics.com. So if you go there and you add any website in here, this site will give you more practical tips on how to speed up your website and ways to actually speed it up with detailed instructions and everything. So first of all, you can go and try gtmetrics. This will help you a lot, and it will give you a lot of good tips. The second thing is to always compress your images, to always have your images in the optimum sizes. I have an article on my website that is really dedicated to only speaking about that, how to resize images. Here in this article, I take an image from 1.2 megabyte to 37.5 kilobytes. That's huge. So you can go there. I will add a link to that article as well. So essentially what you have to do is to make sure they are all in the right sizes. You have the right format. So it's PNG 1.1 megabyte, and JPEG is 130 kilobytes. So that's what the difference makes. And you can see there's almost no difference in the quality. And then of course there's WebP or compressed JPEGs. In this case, you can see that is 52% smaller. So what you have to do is go to tinypng.com and upload your images in here, and it will compress them, so it will make them smaller. Okay, just for the sake of example, I will add just an image in here. So let's say I add this image. So you can see that I input 99 kilobytes and it outputted 46 kilobytes. So you just have to download. So this will make the load of your page faster. And then of course there are WebP images that you can use that are the newest format for images, so this will make your website faster. And the third thing is that you can do is you can connect a CDN. A CDN is essentially a cloud-based delivery network, so like Cloudflare. Okay, I also have an article, and I will add a link in the description of the video where you can learn how to connect Cloudflare. So this will give you, not only will it give you free SSL, it will also make your website faster, because it will load it from the closest cloud network that the user is requesting your website from. So let's say if your visitor is located in Canada and they go to your website, Cloudflare will serve your website through the closest network to that particular person. So it's a cloud-based network, and it will make your website faster, and it's free, of course. And the fourth thing that you should pay attention to, which is I believe the most important part in the entire process, is to have a fast hosting. This is crucial. I cannot stress enough on this point how important it is to have a fast hosting, to have fast servers that will do the job for you. So in my quest for fast websites, I found 10web.io. They are really, really, really huge. They are probably one of the best that I've seen so far, and they are dedicated WordPress hosting. So if you want to host your website on WordPress, if you want to have your website built by WordPress, then I highly recommend you go to 10web and actually buy your hosting from here, because it's really cheap. It's as cheap as any other hosting, but it's I guarantee you that it's so fast and it's really, they have high quality service, so I recommend this service a lot. Here's my discount code for 10web.10. Enter it during checkout and you will get 10% discount whether you buy it monthly or annually. You will have a 10% discount, so go for it.
If I now try to sum up on how to remove CSS and JavaScript, it will be this way. Do not try to remove unused CSS and JavaScript because it will be a waste of time. Instead, try to optimize your website. Try to do what you can actually do. So let's say follow GT Metrics' recommendations, compress your images, make sure they are in small sizes, configure your caching settings, add some caching, connect the CDN like Cloudflare, and of course have fast servers and fast hosting like 10web provides. So if you do all of this, you will never need to go into the trouble of identifying CSSs on every and each page and then measuring how much is being used, and then go the struggle of coding to find and tweak the settings of that particular CSS and JavaScript, because it's an endless struggle, and I promise you. So this was basically it. So my tip is, do not go there. If you like the video, please like it and subscribe to my channel. As always, I'm your man Nar, and cheers.